Hello, welcome to NetVN channel. In this video I will show you how to run Windows 10 on an Android phone. To do this, in addition to an Android phone, I need a Windows computer. In this example I use a Windows 11 computer. On my Windows 11 machine I enable Hyper-V to create a Windows 10 virtual machine. After completing the installation of Hyper-V for Windows 11 computers, you will be asked to restart the computer for the changes to apply. I downloaded the 32-bit Windows 10 operating system installation file from the Microsoft homepage to create a new virtual machine on Hyper-V. Next, I use Hyper-V to create a new Windows 10 virtual machine. You set the virtual machine as you want. Next, you set up the internal memory and set up the network for the virtual machine. Here I will create a new folder to save the hard drive of the Windows 10 virtual machine. In the C partition of the Windows computer, I create a new folder called VM to save the virtual machine's hard drive file. The hard drive size of the virtual machine is 12 GB. Next, I will mount the ISO file prepared to install the operating system for the virtual machine. The virtual machine has been created successfully. Next, I connect to the newly created virtual machine and install the operating system for it. It will take about 15 to 20 minutes to install the Windows 10 operating system for the virtual machine. I will skip the familiar steps when installing Windows 10 operating system. This is my virtual machine when I have finished installing Windows 10 operating system. I will shut down the virtual machine and go to its hard drive storage folder. As mentioned, the virtual machine's hard drive is saved in a folder called VM. Here the hard drive is saved as two different files, so I will merge them into a single file. To merge two files into one, I use Hypervisor. Here you choose the file with the extension of EHDX. You choose Merge. I merged it with the parent file. It will take a few minutes to finish merging the two files together. Then you open the folder named VM and check the result. So two files have been merged into one. I use this file to run Windows 10 virtual machine on Android phone. So what is Hypervisor for Android? In this example, the hypervisor I use is Limbo. You search for it on the internet and download the latest version. I copy and paste the Limbo installer into a folder called VM to upload to my Android phone. To upload these files to my Android phone, I share a folder called VM. I set up folder sharing and allowed everyone to access this folder. The necessary files have been prepared and the folder called VM has been shared. Now I am going to set up to create a virtual machine on my Android phone. I will mirror Android phone screen on Windows computer. In this video I use Android phone Samsung S20 Plus. To transfer files from PC to Android phone, I will install an SMB client. There are many apps that do this. In this example I install an SMB. After completing the installation, I made a connection to the Windows computer with the shared folder. In this example, the Windows computer has an IP address of 192.168.1.2. You then set up a username, password, and shared folder name. Shared folder named VM. The connection is successful. I download the two files shared in the previous part of the video. The files are downloaded successfully. I use the File Manager app on my Android phone to find the downloaded files. Next, I will install the Limbo application using the file with the extension apk. Limbo app has been successfully installed on Android phone. Next, I will import the file with the extension VHDX into the Limbo application to create a Windows 10 virtual machine. To do that, I move the virtual hard drive file to the internal memory of my Android phone. Now I create a new Windows 10 virtual machine using Limbo. You open the Limbo application and set it up as follows. Create a new virtual machine. Name the virtual machine as you like. Next, you set up the hardware for the virtual machine. You set the processor, number of cores and internal memory. Here I set up a quad-core processor and the internal memory size is 2 GB. The virtual machine's hard drive is the file that we prepared from the previous step. Then you set up the virtual machine to boot from the hard drive. Newly created Windows 10 virtual machine on Android phone. Just start it up and wait for the results. Above are the steps to create a Windows 10 virtual machine on an Android phone. Thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe.